हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मोहम्मद रफ़ीक। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल रफ़ीक इंजीनियरिंग ड्राइंग। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन और फर्स्ट मॉडल ऑफ प्रोजेक्शंस ऑफ प्लेन इंक्लाइंड टू बोथ द प्लेन्स, दैट इज HP एंड VP। सो देर आर बेसिकली फोर मॉडल्स। व्हाट आर दोस? आई विल शो यू हियर। इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज रेस्टिंग बाय इट्स साइड, ओके, रेस्टिंग बाय वन ऑफ इट्स साइड। सो देर आर एज रेस्टिंग और साइड रेस्टिंग, द मीनिंग इज सेम। अनदर कैटेगरी इज कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग। सो हाउ मेनी कैटेगरीज आर देर? एज रेस्टिंग, कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग, एज इज ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज साइड, सो मीनिंग इज सेम। देन वेयर दे आर रेस्टिंग, इन HP और इन VP, लाइक दैट। एज और कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग इन HP, टू केसेस। एज एंड कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग इन VP, देन टू मोर केसेस। सो टोटल फोर केसेस, फोर मॉडल्स और फोर क्वेश्चंस वी विल डू वन बाय वन। दिस इज एज रेस्टिंग इन HP, फर्स्ट कैटेगरी। लेटर वी विल सी कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग इन HP, देन वी विल गो फॉर एज रेस्टिंग इन VP, देन कॉर्नर रेस्टिंग इन VP, ओके। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। व्हाट दे आर सेइंग, दे हैव गिवन प्रोजेक्शंस ऑफ हेक्सागन, वी नीड टू ड्रा साइड और एज, लेंथ हाउ मच? 30 mm, रेस्टिंग बाय वन ऑफ इट्स एजेस, रेस्टिंग वेयर? इन HP, एंड द एज विच इज रेस्टिंग, दैट एज ओनली इज ऑल्सो मेकिंग 60° टू द VP। सो हाईलाइट is required, I'm doing there. Then its surface is making an angle of 45°, surface is making 45° to the HP. So these are the things. Let us try to understand by help of one hexagon which is available with me right now here. HAB or any side you take, it is of 30 mm, all the sides of the hexagon are of 30 mm. So it is resting by any one edge in HP. So assume my hand is horizontal plane and this board is vertical plane. So hexagon is resting by its edge on HP, like this, resting by edge on HP over. Then it is inclined at 60° to the VP, which is inclined at 60° to the VP. The edge by which it is resting, this edge only with respect to VP, it is making 60° like this. Got it? Let us try to elaborate this. Assume this edge AB, it is resting on HP, that is over. This edge AB, you take or you assume it as a line, okay? A line with respect to VP, now it is parallel. With respect to VP, now it is perpendicular. With respect to VP, it is, if it is at 60°, it will be like this, okay? So here, the edge is in HP and at 60° to the VP, means either you rotate it in this direction or you rotate it in this direction, it's up to you. So like that, assume this is the base edge, like this, just now I have shown you, right? So edge is in HP and with respect to VP, it is making 60° like this, or 60° with respect to VP, you can tilt in this direction or you can tilt in this direction, it's up to you. We have the option in the projection of planes, okay, in HP and with respect to VP, 60°, this is over. And the surface of hexagon, this surface of hexagon with respect to HP, how much? Making 45° to the HP, okay. So once again, let's combine the question. The edge by which it is resting in HP, the edge is resting in HP, and the edge which is resting in HP, this edge with respect to VP, this edge is making 60°. And whereas the surface of the hexagon is now parallel to HP, perpendicular to HP, as per the question, the surface of hexagon is at 45° like this. This is the final position of the hexagon. If you see the front view, this is the thing. Okay, now let us see how to draw this. So whenever you are dealing with the projection of planes inclined to both the planes HP and VP, there are certain rules, or you can imagine it as a trick to solve. So first trick is that whatever surface angle is given, that surface angle need to be assumed to 0°, okay? Surface angle to be assumed, this is assume surface angle to be 0, and edge angle, whatever is given with respect to whom, that is also doesn't matter. Surface is given with respect to HP or VP, doesn't matter. Whatever angle is given, that will be assumed 0. Edge angle, or it is also edge or side angle, side, that is this one, with respect to VP or HP doesn't matter. Directly whatever given, that to be assumed to direct 90 degree. So surface angle here how much it is given? 45 degree. That we are assuming 0 degree. Edge angle how much it is given? 90 degree. That we are assuming. Edge angle given 60 degree. That we are assuming 90 degree. So how the problem will be? Let us see. Surface angle 0. Edge angle instead of 60 we are taking it at 90 degree like this. So this is the first position. So whenever you got a question like edge is resting, it is given is resting by one of its side or edge. So side resting in HP means you need to draw the hexagon in this way. Side resting means this is the thing. If they give you corner resting, then the diagram will be like this. Got it? This is edge resting diagram. This is corner resting diagram in HP. If they give you in VP, the same thing will be upside. Edge resting in VP means same diagram will come here. Edge corner resting in VP means same diagram will come here. So our question is edge resting in HP. So this is the first step. So wherever the true shape of the object is visible to you, that diagram you should draw first. That is from top view. It is like this. Side is 30. Okay. Assume this is A, B, C, D, E, F. If we project it vertically upward, we will be getting like this. First comes A, then F. So the front view line is this one. A dash bracket, F dash, B dash bracket, E dash, then C dash bracket, D dash. Okay. Top view is like this. Top view is like this. That is this way. This is the diagram. And front view you will be able to see one line. Okay. This is the thing. Then surface making how much angle? 45 degree. While giving the angle or while restoring the angle, surface to be given first priority, edge to be given second priority. So now earlier surface was 45 degree. We have assumed 0 degree. Edge 60 degree, we have assumed 90 degree. Okay. Now we have to give this original angles to the back. That is 45 degree we need to restore. And we need to restore instead of 60, 90. So surface first. Surface now 0. Now if we give 45 degree to the surface, it will be like this. So in the front, what you are able to see? One line. So same length you measure and redraw it at 45 degree. Okay, so surface angle we have assumed 0 degree, edge angle we have assumed 90 degree. Whatever given and with respect to HP or VP is given, that is also doesn't matter. So this same measure, redraw it at 45 degree. This length you need to measure from your diagram, that is from your front view. So this is A dash bracket F dash, C dash bracket D dash, then center point this you measure, or it will be in midpoint if you are accurate. This is B dash bracket E dash. Now project all the points in the top view. And project this from here. This A, this D and F should be in one line. And similarly A and C should be in one line. This you can take up to here also, doesn't matter. If you want, you can erase. There's no such hard and fast rule. But projection line should be taken thin, XY line medium, whereas front view, top view, all should be dark. This you need to remember. This is called line weights. So this is the top view. So top view is reduced. Why? Because the surface is inclined. So from top, if you see, it is compressed one. Okay. Like this. This is compressed. So numbering we will give A, B, C, D, E, and this is the F. Now the edge by which it is resting, that is this edge which is in HP, this edge should make with respect to VP, right now it is perpendicular. With respect to VP, the edge by which it is resting, it should be at 60 degree like this. So what we will do, either you take 60 degree in this direction or this direction, doesn't matter. So now I am taking 60 degree angle in this direction, okay. This line you take here, 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 anywhere according to the space availability, and at 60 degree line, this also any length, we need to transfer this box. Which box? This hexagon we need to shift here first. To shift that hexagon, we need one box to enclose. So we are enclosing this hexagon in a box. Measure this box, this width and this distance, and transfer here. So after measurement, I'm transferring the box here. It will be like this. So we have successfully transferred. Measurement and transfer. Here it should be 90 degree. Many students, they'll draw a box like this, like parallelogram, or they may do like this. This of course they'll take straight, and they may go like this. So no parallelogram here. It should be at 90 degree. Let us continue. Now a distance with respect to this corner, how much distance it is, you mark a. Similarly, all distances will be exact same if you are accurate. So a and e will be same distance. The same distance will be applied here also, because if you are accurate, this will be at correct place. If it is not matching, this distance, all four distances will be same from their respective corners. If it is not matching, then somewhere you have done inaccuracy. So AF ED over, this is E, this is B. Let's join all the points. We'll be getting hexagon like this. That's all. Now project all the points here, and from here you take the projectors horizontally. You'll be getting final front view. Okay, this is anyhow on the ground line, no need to worry. A, first A, and from here A. So both will give you this A dash. Then B, where is B here? This one. So this B and this B gives you another B dash. Like that, we need to project all the points. Let us continue this and finish it off. This is point C. This is E. Now it's time to project C. D, E, and then F. See here, E and F and C and B are close. If you are drawing in your notebook, if you are getting like this or like that, this side doesn't matter, because we are doing with lot of accuracy rather than me, because I am going with, you know, random 60 degree, random 30 mm, so I may be inaccurate. AB over C, C is here and this C is here. So we can mark here C dash, then D, D is here and D is also common line for this D. E, it is going this side, and here is the E. F is this side, okay. Then where is F? Here at the ground line. This is F dash. Join all the points A to B, B to C, C to D, E, and then F, then F to A. So this is how the final front view of the hexagon you have got. So just I am highlighting, this is the final front view which you are able to see right now, and this is the final top view. Okay, box also you need to keep it in light color. Okay, if you have any doubts, you are most welcome to comment. Please like, subscribe and share my channel. Okay, thanks for watching. In a next video we will see model 2, that is question number 2. Thank you.